Good morning. Welcome to Lily of the Valley Missionary Baptist Church. We come this morning to let the Holy Spirit have his way in this building today. We ask that Jesus just come and touch our hearts, our minds, and our soul, and lead us and guide us closer and closer to him. Amen, amen, and amen.
5:3-7. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Be not wise to thine own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. I have read Proverbs 3:5-7. May the Lord have a blessing to the hearers and doers of his word. Amen. Everybody, can you please bow your heads and close your eyes? Father God, thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you for the loving us there once again in another day. And let your blood rush through our bodies. Let your blood shares through our bodies. Let your blood heals both of us. And heals the one that's in the hospital. And heal the ones that's not in the hospital. Give the people that's not in the hospital the power to stay out. And give the people in it to have the power to get out. Let everybody have their own ways of healing. Heal all of us. Heal us to the point where we just stay healthy forever. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Don't pray like they used to pray. Time has made a change. Oh, people don't pray like they used to pray. Time has made a change. Oh, people don't pray like they used to pray. Time has made a change. No, time has made a change. People don't love like they used to love. Time has made a change. Oh, people don't love like they used to love. Time has made a change. Oh, people don't love like they used to love. Time has made a change. You know time. People don't sing like they used to sing. Time has made a change. You know time sang like they used to sing. Time has made a change. People don't sing like they used to sing. Time has made a change. You know time has made a change. Tom, Tom, Tom. Tom has made a change. Oh, Tom, Tom, Tom. Tom has made a change. Tom, Tom, Tom. Tom has made a change. No, Tom has made a change.
Our minds and our souls on Jesus Christ. Most holy and righteous Father, our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ, we realize, dear Lord, that you are the Alpha and the Omega. We realize you are the beginning and the end. You are the author and the finisher of our faith. And we realize today that you are still in control. That you are got all power in your hands. So we say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for all that you have done for us, dear Lord. All that you are doing in our lives, dear Lord. Heavenly Father, you have brought us a mighty long way, and we realize you didn't bring us this far just to leave us. So we say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Heavenly Father, we ask that you continue to be with us, dear Lord. Continue to lead us, continue to guide us, continue to have your way in our lives, dear Lord. Heavenly Father, you said in your words, cast all your cares upon me, because I care for you, dear Lord. So we are looking for you, dear Lord. We are looking for you, dear Lord. We are looking to the hills, which cometh our help, because all our help coming from you, dear Lord. We realize we can't make it without you, dear Lord. So continue to touch us, dear Lord, and be with us, dear Lord, and have your way in our house, dear Lord. Have your way in the nursing homes, dear Lord. Have your way in the schools, dear Lord. Have your way, dear Lord, in the hospital, dear Lord. Have your way in this world today, dear Lord. Heavenly Father, we ask that you lead us. You guide us, dear Lord. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord. And no matter what's going on in this world today, dear Lord, we know that you have all power in your hands, dear Lord. So we just turning everything over to you, dear Lord. We trusting and believing in you, dear Lord, that you gonna make everything all right, dear Lord. That you gonna fix all that's going wrong in this world today, dear Lord. So we just trusting and believing in you, dear Lord. Heavenly Father, we just ask that you just help us keep our hearts. Help us keep our minds. Help us keep our souls on you, dear Lord. Help us stay focused on you, dear Lord. Let us Don't let us get caught up in the mess that's in this world today, dear Lord. But let us stay caught up on you, dear Lord. Heavenly Father, we pray a blessing upon our church today, dear Lord. Lily of the Valley and our pastor, Stephen Owens, dear Lord. Continue to be with him, dear Lord. Continue to lead him, dear Lord. Continue to guide him, dear Lord. And bless all churches that's opened up in your name, dear Lord. Heavenly Father, let your Holy Spirit just continue to have his way. Have your way in this world today, dear Lord. Touch us today, dear Lord. Be with us today, dear Lord. And lead us and guide us today. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' holy, 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 and righteous name, we do pray. Amen and amen.
A spiritual, this is a Good morning. Giving praise to God and to all those assembled. Truly, this is the day that the Lord has made. We need to rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. Our prayer is for the church to come back together. But we know that God is in control of all things. Amen. I want to share with you on today from the book of Romans, the 12th chapter of Romans, the second verse, Romans 12:2. And it says these words, "And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God." Amen. God bless you. Amen. On the reading of God's word. Amen. I'd like to talk on the subject, change your thoughts and it will change you. Change your thoughts and it will change you. Amen. 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 Do you know that in your right now is everything you need to be great in the sight of God, to be successful Christians, to be the person God wants you to be? Listen, you are equipped, blessed, talented, and empowered, bold, and confident. But it's up to you to bring it out. How do you do this? The Bible says God transformed you into a new person by changing the way you think. When you let go from a small thinking, when you stop limiting God, then you will open up your life to your dream and fullness of God's blessings. But first you have to shut off the comment others have said about you and replace them, amen, with God, what God says about you. The transform and change you is going to be released, amen. An amazing new person will take place. You will see the bless you, the prosperous you, the confident you, the talent you, the healthy you, the happy you. On the inside of us is a person who is created in the image of God. So today we're going to talk about change your thoughts and it will change you. The first thing I want you to see is focus on what God says we can do. Romans 8:5 says, "Those who are controlled by the Holy Spirit think about things that pleases the Spirit." Amen. We are not limited, amen, by negative thoughts. We are not to be restricted by narrow thinking about things I can't do. But instead, that leads by what God wants to accomplish in you. It is human nature to gravity toward the negative. Even the optimist has to work, amen, at seeing the glass 1/4 full instead of 3/4 empty. Listen, brothers and sisters, negative thinking leads to negative talking. Negative talking leads to conflict, amen, frustration, and angry. Amen. Just go home and start talking about how awful things were at work. Throw down your keys on the counter and pop down on the couch and see if your spouse would run over and want to snuggle with you. Amen. Most likely you are going to end up sleeping on the couch all along before the night is over. Listen, God can change us. God help us go through the transformation. It is not all up to God, but part of it is up to us too. Get your thinking in line with God. The Bible tells us, amen, in Proverbs 4:23, "Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flow from it." There is a greater inside of you. There is a greater mother. There is a greater person inside of you, a greater man inside of you, a greater person inside you. When you think things are never going to change, when you think things are never getting better, then that kind of thinking determines your course of action. Focus on what God said, amen, he can do. The Bible tells us, amen, in Psalms 27, it says, for as he thinketh in his heart, and so is he. So the first thing I want you to see, focus, amen, on what God said we can do. The second thing I want you to see in the scripture, change your thoughts. Change your thought. The scripture we read, Romans 12 and 2, it says, be ye not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. It's a fresh start, y'all. Tomorrow is a new day. This is what I have to do. Many times God has to change me from barely getting by to realize I am blessed by the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. You hear what I'm saying? I am blessed. Amen. He has created us to rise above everything and everyone else, to succeed, amen, where others had failed, to excel where others had not done well, to stand out and surpass what others have left undone, to outlive, amen, everything else. You can't and you will never amount to anything, amen, unless the negative comment, the gossip, the judgment of others, and the heartfelt or hurtful criticism. Amen, amen, and amen. You know, God has a plan for our life. Amen. But we have to learn, amen, that we got to change our thoughts. Amen. If you don't change your thoughts, then you won't amount up to anything. So I want to make sure that you understand that you got to change your thought. Look what it says. It says, be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing. Amen. You got to renew your mind. Amen. And change your ways. Change your thoughts. You hear what I'm saying, don't you? Amen. I'm here to let you know that God can make something great out of you. I decided a long time ago that I got to change, amen, my thoughts. And I got to change my ways in order for me to see God. But you have to be transformed. You know what I'm talking about, transformed. You can't live the same life you used to live. You can't go to places like you used to go to. You know, you can't say the thing that you used to say. You have to be changed, amen, from the inside. I mean, we change the outside. We can change our clothes and look different. But if the inside is all jacked up, you're in bad shape. So you got to learn, amen, a change have to come sooner or later. A change have to come. The third thing I want you to see is get rid of the wrong programming that has been put in you. Let me say it again. Get rid of the wrong programming, amen, that has been put in you. The Bible tells us, amen, in Judges 6 and 13, saying, Gideon said to him, please, sir, if the Lord is with us, why then has all this happened to us? And where are all his wonderful deeds that our father, amen, that our father re-encountered to us, saying, did not the Lord bring us out from Egypt? But now the Lord has forsaken us and given us, amen, into the land of the Midians. Let me tell you, amen, let me tell you who you really are. You are blessed. You are talent. You are valuable. You are bold. You are handmade, amen, by the Almighty Creator. Amen. Handmade. Think about, amen, who God say you are. Victorious. Successful. But Gideon said, I'm not so nervous. I feel so abandoned by God. Where is the Lord of our ancestor? You say, why has God forsaken us and given up on me? You see, the enemy, Satan, wants to keep you thinking negative thoughts. He wants to program us for defeat. He said the problem is never going to end. He said this temptation is too big for you to overcome. He doesn't want you to break out. He wants to keep you, amen, sliding backwards. Amen, to not grow, to not mature. Brothers and sisters, when I first started out in the ministry over 30 years ago, amen, I was much younger, amen, and very insecure. Someone could say one negative thing, and I would get too discouraged, so discouraged. Amen, I would try to change to make sure everybody liked me. But now my faith has grown. I don't need to the approval of people. All I desire is approval from God. I know that I'm doing my best to serve God. Amen. I would not take the credit or the praise, amen, when things are going good, because I give all the glory and all the honor to God. But neither will I go home defeated just because nobody else shouted. Amen. You should not go home disappointed. Even, amen, if you are the only one singing, amen, Gideon was called to lead against this army. The angel spoke to him and said, "You are a mighty man of fearless courage." Listen, brothers and sisters, I am convinced that Gideon looked around and asked, amen, "Are you talking about me?" Amen. Gideon was afraid. Gideon was intimidated. But God didn't call him for what he was. But God called him, amen, for what he could become. And I believe a lot of people become a lot of great things. But you got to get rid of the wrong programming in your life. Amen. You might feel weak, but God called you to be strong. You might feel like, amen, that you're all alone, but God called you to be confident. Amen. You might think you can't do it, but God said you are able. Y'all do hear what I'm talking about. You, amen. God said you are able. Believe, amen, that there is mercy for every mistake. Amen. That you are who God say you are. You may be living in disappointment. You may be thinking life is unfair. You may be focused, amen, amen, on missed opportunity. But there's still God in you. There's a royal blood in your veins. Can I tell you, you are a child of the Most High God. You have a spirit, amen, in you. You have to start claiming, amen, that God is able. The only thing that's holding you back right now is your thoughts. You hear what I'm saying? The only thing that's holding you back is your thought. Some people think that they can change. They can never change. But I'm here to tell you, everybody can change. Some people think, amen, that you can't do it. But I'm here to tell you, you can do all things through Christ that strengthens you. I'm here to tell you that God is able to transform you around, to turn you around, to teach you that everything is going to be all right. Do I got any witness that God will? I say God will make a way out of no way. But I'm here to tell you to trust in the Lord. Lean not to that all understanding. Ain't he all right today? I say, ain't he all right? Shall yeah, shall yeah. He died, didn't he die? All day Friday, all day Saturday, but early Sunday morning, I said early Sunday morning, came out of the grave with all power in his hand. Ain't he all right? Shayem, Shayem, I know he's all right. Ain't he all right? Won't he do it? Won't he make a way? I say, won't he do it? Won't he show up on time? I'm here to tell you, change your thoughts. Change your thoughts. And it will change you.
Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you. Amen. God keep you. Is our prayer. Is our prayer. Again, be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. God bless you. God keep you.
Today we heard the word of God. Change your thoughts. That will bring a change in your life. We want you to understand today that you can't separate yourself from sin. You can't separate yourself from your failures. It's the blood of Christ that will cover those and blot those sins out so that God remembers them no more. We want you to understand today that change can come, but it starts with you. It starts with your acceptance of Christ as your Lord and Savior. Some of us may need to rededicate ourselves to that, but we want you to understand today that we know you can make it through. Pray this with me, if you will. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come before your throne of mercy and grace today. Father, we believe that Jesus is your only begotten Son. We believe that he came for the remission of sin. We believe that he rose on the third day with all power. Father, we ask that you allow the Holy Spirit to come into our lives, come into our heart. And Father, we want to be a part of the kingdom. Father, for we know that you created us to be with you in heaven. And that's what we want to do most, Father. We want to be pleasing in thy sight and not in the sight of man. Father, we ask this in the bountiful name of Jesus. Amen. Now, if you prayed that prayer with me today, don't stop there. Continue to move forward. Continue to do what pleases God and not man. We want you to understand that we know what's going on in this world. We see it. This disease is a bad thing. But you know, this too shall pass. We want you to know that if you desire to worship with us again on Sundays, go to Facebook or to YouTube. We're called The Lily Church. Once this is all over, if you desire to come to a place to worship with us, we'd love to have you. Because we know that you'll get the truth, but most importantly, you'll get love. We want you to understand that we're located at 134 Cardiff, San Antonio, Texas, 78220. If you need to talk to someone, because we're here to listen, you can reach us at 210-223-5975. May God add a special blessing to your heart today, because we're here to tell you that God has already given the Holy Spirit charge to touch your heart so that you can come out of darkness into light. God bless you and keep you the same. Amen.
Amen. God bless you all. Thank you all. Amen for all that you have done. Amen. God is an awesome God. God is a good God. Amen. We ask you, members, continue to be prayerful. And I think I told you last week, take out some time every day to read your Bible and pray. Amen. That's important that we do that. Read our Bible and pray. Amen. We know that this virus that we are facing, we know that God is in control of all things. And as he said before, this too shall pass. Amen. We continue to ask you to be prayerful. And I want also to commend you all that you're doing an awesome job in your giving. I want to personally say thank you. And I know God appreciated it as well. Amen. Because we still have responsibility here at the church. Amen. We have GiveAfy. Then you go on GiveAfy or you go to Cash App. Amen. The Cash App. Go to the Lily Church and you'll find the app, the Lily Church. You will find how to give and what you want to give to the church. You can also mail your tithes offering in. Amen. You also can just stop by the church Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Amen. To drop off your money. Now, we know next Sunday is First Sunday. It's our Communion Sunday. So someone will be here Friday and Saturday. Friday from the 10 to 2, someone will be here to hand you a communion cup. Then on Saturday, someone will be here between 10 and 1. So we encourage you to come by Friday or Saturday to pick up your communion. So that way next Sunday we can all do it together. Amen. We may be at home doing it, but we all be together. So stop by and get your communion. I want to tell you also that God loves you, and I love you too. God bless you. God keep you. Have a great and wonderful day in the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. God is good, and all the time God is good. Stay tuned. Amen. We do have a prayer line. Amen. That number will show up in a few minutes. God bless you.